Michigan head coach Jim Harbaugh may be eyeing a return to the NFL. According to a report, Harbaugh's reps have been testing the waters to see if there's any interest in the head coach. However, this morning, Harbaugh issued a statement to his players' parents saying the reports are, quote, total crap, that he doesn't even have a representative or an agent. So, Shannon, should an NFL team hire Harbaugh?
No. Skip, he because he has a short shelf life. If he goes to a rebuilding situation, by the time he starts to get it turned around, you're sick of him. He grinds on people. And when he was in, and everybody's like, well, you see what he did with Stanford? Yep. And that's how he got the job at San Francisco. And you see what he's doing at Michigan? You see what happened, Skip, what you're starting to see when he has a team in Michigan and they have the same, and the other opposing team has the same level of talent, he loses. He hadn't beat Michigan State. He hadn't beat Ohio State yet. Beat Michigan State, what, once? So at some point in time in the NFL is what? All the teams are talented. And the team that he had in San Francisco was immensely talented. People don't realize just how talented that football team was, Skip. They were loaded. They were a big, physical football team. But, Skip, he starts to grind on you. I know people that played under him and coached with him. He grinds on you. And if after a while you're like, I'm ready to either – he go his way, or I go my way, but we need to separate. Hmm. And that's what happens.
If I owned an NFL team and I was struggling, I would jump at the chance to hire Jim Harbaugh to take over my franchise.
Michigan did that. How'd he look?
Well, that's a college team. Oh. And by the way, when he started at the University of San Diego, he immediately turned that program mm-hmm. completely around. And then he goes to Stanford and completely turned that program mm-hmm. around. And then he goes to the 49ers and he goes the first 3 years to the NFC Championship mm-hmm. game. And he won one of them and nearly won a Super Bowl. It cost him at the end of the game. There was a controversial non-call. They could have won that game, the Super Bowl. This is the man. This is what shocks me about you. But this is the man who had the vision and guts to elevate Colin Kaepernick mm-hmm. into the starting lineup mm-hmm. in place of Alex Smith at midseason mm-hmm. and stick with him
yep.
and go all the way to the last play of the Super Bowl that should have been called pass interference, mm-hmm. and I believe they would have won the game. So all he did was go as the San Francisco coach 44-19-1. Is that good?
Yeah.
That's great. He went 5-3 in the postseason. And for what it's worth, he's 43-16 at Michigan, but obviously he has not beaten any of the good teams. Mm-mm. He's 1-3 in bowl games.
Yeah, and yep. 1-10 against
one
top 10
against
teams.
Top 10. I get that. I don't know why it went wrong because that's his alma mater, and I thought he was going home to turn it around.
But, Skip, here's the thing. But in San Francisco, he had that great record, but then what happened? He wore on people.
Okay.
And they couldn't wait to get him up out of
there. Well, if I owned a team and I thought I could get 3 great years out of him, I'd let him wear on me all he wanted to.
Yeah, okay. But here's the thing, Skip. If you're in a rebuild, by the time he starts to start, you see any resemblance of it turning around, you're ready for him to go. Hmm. Because like you said, you read his resume in San Francisco and they couldn't wait to get him up out of there. So what does that tell you, Skip? What is that telling you?
That they didn't want him gone for the first 3 years because they were rolling.
Exactly.
Right?
So the first 3 years should have brought him, what, at least another 2-3 years? But they're like, nah, we good.
Hmm. I'm shocked at what he hasn't been able to do at Michigan because I thought he could recruit the top prospects from around the country, and his recruiting methods were a little wacky to the point I think he started turning kids off.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you want somebody to hold your you know, the chain mark at your ball game or yeah. go in your treehouse,
yeah.
that's your guy. But if you want to play for the national championship, go on down there and see St. Nick.
Mm.
Or go see Dabo.
They have a chance
go see Lincoln Riley.
To get back on track yeah. this weekend. They're playing Notre Dame, Notre Dame.
That's a big deal. That's a hot seat game if
they're
they lose that
track.
At home.
You want Michigan?
No. I don't.
Well, I thought
what do you mean?
Wait a second. I already cleaned you out on Michigan last year.
Hold on. Tell about
you bet me 5 cases okay. that they would lose, five games?
Hold on. This is what I don't understand yeah. about you. You don't want to take Michigan, but if you own a team, you're going to hire him as your coach.
Do you realize how many top draft picks they lost on defense? And I knew they had them last year, which
yeah,
is why I took that bet.
That's why I wouldn't hire him. Yeah. With all those top draft picks, he ain't win nothing.
Yeah.
That's why I wouldn't hire him, Jenny.
They were all hurt at the Ohio State.
Oh, Lord.
Were they not injured? They were injured.
For the whole year?
No, at Ohio State. They were all hurt or they got hurt during the game.
Bush
even Devin injured. Bush got injured.
Yeah, that was you a tough
David
one.
Long got injured. Chase Winovich was already injured.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
No, I'm not.
There were injuries.
What about the previous year?
I can't defend him there,
if
but I can sure defend him at the 49ers.
That would be big for them to get back on track in terms of his reputation. But enough from that story, because I've got a weirder one. This might be one of the most bizarre stories of the day. It involves Odell Beckham, Tom Brady, and goat hair. Goat hair. You don't want to. Our hot topic of the day, sponsored by Burger King. Lonzo Ball and the Pelicans began their season in Toronto taking on the reigning champs. Through three quarters, the Pelicans trailed by 2 points, and Lonzo had played the third most minutes on the team. But head coach Alvin Gentry benched Lonzo for the entire fourth quarter, along with starter Derek Favors. Ultimately, the Pelicans lose by 8 in overtime. Lonzo played 3.5 of the 5 minutes in OT. And Skip, I want to know, what do you make of Alvin Gentry benching Lonzo in the fourth?
Look, I was pleasantly surprised by how well Lonzo started the game right out of the box last night, because he came out with conviction and supreme confidence and actually played very well against the defending champs in Toronto on TNT. Mm-hmm. But then I was unpleasantly shocked by what Alvin Gentry did to Lonzo Ball with 6:29 left in the third quarter, as Jenny points out.
Yeah.
He benched him.
Yep.
Not just for the rest of the third quarter, for the rest of the game regulation. All of the rest of the third quarter and all of the fourth quarter, Lonzo had to sit. Lonzo did not look happy to me on the bench, because he should not have looked happy. Mm-mm. Because Alvin Gentry, and I'm a fan of Alvin's. I've known him forever. But Alvin Gentry did to Lonzo what Luke Walton often did. Lonzo got Luke Walton again last night. What would Luke do through the first couple of years in L.A.? He would play him for a stretch, and then he would bench him bizarrely for a long stretch.
Yep.
And that set off LeVar Ball, who quickly called for Luke's job, that he wanted him fired, and claimed that Luke had, he sat right here and said it, Luke had lost the team starting with these bizarre benchings of Lonzo Ball. So what really disturbed me about this was that Lonzo did play so well that he didn't deserve to be benched. Can we see the first three that he took and made? This is early in the game. He just comes straight down the floor and he pulls up deep three. Watch this. And rips it. And that looked like a new guy. And then he pulls off this inside out pass that is rare.
That was a great gifted pass.
And it was something. It was, there's the shot. Woo. Here's the pass. Inside out. There are just not many. LeBron could probably pull that off, but there aren't many who in the history of this league could pull off that little inside out wristy, you know, bend pass. And so he's playing well. He gets benched. And I realized that Alvin was trying to ride a hot, weird lineup that he found featuring Frank Jackson and Josh Hart in the backcourt with Drew Holiday. But then double weird was we go all the way through regulation. They're tied. And he sends the starting five back onto the floor. And Lonzo's like jumping, doing jumping jacks on the court to try to warm up. When he got the tip in overtime, he's hopping up the court like trying to get his legs back in motion, because he needed to stretch again.
Right.
You needed another pregame warm-up, right?
Or go get on the bike or something.
Yeah, go something, because that's just flat-out unfair.
Yeah.
What is Alvin thinking? And I didn't see any quotes from him. Maybe we'll have some today. I'm not sure he was even asked about it after the game. But all I know is this was an opening night bad sign for Lonzo Ball in New Orleans, and I don't get it.
Skip, I can't disagree with you. Because when I'm watching, I was like, okay, he went to the bench. He's going to take his rest.
Sure.
He's going to come back in the third quarter. In the fourth quarter.
Yeah.
So that's what I'm thinking. I'm like, okay, normal. Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't think anything about it.
Right.
Lonzo's going to come back at the start of the fourth quarter. He's going to finish this game out.
All right.
Okay,
he doesn't come out and say, well, maybe he's getting them extended rest.
Hmm.
And here we are at 6 minutes. And he's still not back in the ballgame.
Hmm.
So now I'm starting to think, is he hurt? I mean, I did too.
I thought, is he ill?
So,
and maybe we'll find out today he was under the weather, but I don't know that.
So at this point, Skip, at 6 minutes, I cut the volume on. So I want to hear if he's hurt or not. Because I'm not listening to the volume. I said, well, maybe this ain't. So still, nothing. Skip, this is not a good sign. Because it tells me is that they're viewing Lonzo as someone they don't have to have on the floor late in the ball game.
Yeah, because if you're the leader and the new point guard, you have to put him back in the game midway fourth quarter, right?
Yes, and Skip, remember, he was one of the linchpin pieces that they wanted
what we read
for Anthony Davis.
Okay.
So.